Hi, I'm Yutong. I'm a GPU core developer here at Folding at Home. Today, I want to give you guys an update on what we've been working on over the past few months. Let's take a look at the three major components of GPU core development. First off, we have OpenMM, our open source library for AMD simulations. It's used by both FAHBench and Core17. Now, FAHBench is our official benchmarking tool for GPUs, and it supports all OpenCL compatible devices. We're also very happy to tell you guys that it's been recently added to Anandtech's GPU test suite. And Core17 is what your phone and home clients use to do science. And by the way, all those arrows just mean that the entire development process is interconnected. So let's take a step back in time. Last year, in October, we conceived Core17. And we had three major goals in mind. We wanted a core that was going to be faster, more stable, and to be able to support more types of simulations than just implicit solvent. But because of how our old Core 15 and 16 was written, it was in fact easier for us to just rewrite the core from scratch. So in November, we started rewriting some of the key parts to replace pre-existing functionality. Over 2 months, in January, things began to come together. Our work server, assignment server, and client was modified to support Core 17. We also started an internal test team for the first time ever, using an IRC channel on Freenode to provide real-time testing feedback. In February, Core 17 had a public beta of over 1,000 GPUs, and we learned a lot of valuable things. One of them was that the core wasn't actually all that much faster, it seemed, on NVIDIA, though on AMD things certainly looked brighter. And things still crashed occasionally, and bugs were certainly still present. So we went back to the drawing board to improve the core. In April, we added a lot of new optimizations and bug fixes to OpenMM. We tested a Linux core for the first time ever on GPUs, and our internal testing team had grown to over 30 people. And that brings us to today. We now support many more types of simulations, ranging from explicit solvent to large systems of up to 100,000 atoms. We improved the stability of our cores, and we now have a sustainable code base. We added support for Linux for the first time, and it's also really fast. And I'm sure the burning question on all of your minds are, just how fast is it? Well, let's take a look. On the GDX Titan, we saw it going from 50,000 points per day to over 120,000 points per day. On the GTX 680, we saw it go from 30,000 points per day to over 80,000 points per day. On the AMD HD 7970, we saw it go from 10,000 points per day to over 110,000 points per day. And on the AMD HD 7870, we saw it jump from 5,000 points per day to over 50,000 points per day. Now, we never want to rest on our laurels for too long. And in fact, we're already planning support for the Intel devices in the near future, such as the i7s, the integrated graphics cards, and Xeon Phis. We plan to add more projects to Folding at Home as time goes on, so researchers within our group can investigate more systems of interest. And as always, we want things to be faster. Let's go back to the beginning again for a second. And here's how you guys can help us out. If you're a programmer, we invite you to contribute to the open source OpenMM project, which will be available on GitHub at the end of the month at github.com/cmtk/openmm. If you're an enthusiast and you like to build state-of-the-art computers, we encourage you to run FAHBench and also join our internal testing team on Freenode. If you're a donor, we'd like you guys to help us spread the word about Phone at Home and bring more people and their machines, of course. Now, before I wrap things up, there are some people I'd like to thank. Our internal testers are on the right-hand side, and they've been absolutely instrumental in providing me with real-time feedback regarding our tests. And we couldn't have done this as fast without them. On the left-hand side are the people within the Pony group. Joseph and Peter are programmers like me. DeWalker and TJ helped set up many of our projects. Christian and Robert have always been there for support and feedback. But wait, one last thing. This week, I'll be doing a questions and answers section on Reddit at reddit.com/r/folding. So if you've got questions, come drop by and hang out with us. Thanks, and bye-bye.